Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Bree.
I'm Haley.
All right, so then we're gonna go into some things that are more specifically pertaining to logging the most accurately.
So if I wanted to scan the barcode, say I'm using a bag of oatmeal, I'm just gonna put it in my lunch. So I would go into here and at the top, there's a barcode scanner button. So I'm gonna hit scan, it's gonna bring me to my camera. This barcode is on the bottom here. So then I would just take that, line that up there, and then it should show me what the label says on the food. So that's something I also like to double check. The label says 35 grams, 1/3 cup is 140 calories. So I look at that and everything adds up. So then I'm just gonna hit the check mark and I easily added that to my food log there. All right, so then Haley's gonna show you how to find the best fit for what you're actually consuming through the options that you can find.
So say for example, for snack, I'm having a Honeycrisp apple. I'm gonna go to snack, search for a food, and then I wanna be as specific as possible. So instead of just writing apple, I might write medium Honeycrisp apple. Just trying to be as specific with the brand and everything. So I'm gonna hit search. And then there's a bunch of different things that come up here. So first thing I would do is try to scroll for a check mark. If I don't see any green check marks, which means that it's a verified entry, then I'm just gonna look at a few and compare them. So the first one, I don't wanna choose this because it's not showing it in any specific measurement. It's just saying in diameter, which I'm not gonna take a measuring thing and measure my apple. So the next one's measuring in grams, which is pretty sweet. And I just kinda look at the macros, 25 grams of carbs. I might check one more. Something here, this one is raw, 100 grams, so it's a different serving size, but again, it has carbs, which we know an apple is carbohydrates because it's fruit. So those look pretty good. I'm gonna take the Honeycrisp medium apple, and then the next thing I can do is, say for example, my apple weighed, I cut it off and I didn't use the core, right? I don't wanna use the core. Say it weighed 150 grams. What I can do is I can go into the serving size, choose 1 gram, and then for the number of servings, I could type in 150. Make sure you hit decimal, not fractions, And then I can type in 150, and that means I ate 150 grams of the Honeycrisp apple, which gave me 20 grams of carbs, and then I'm just gonna hit save. You just wanna make sure that you're using something accurate and you're not just typing in apple because it's not gonna help you find the best entry.
Something to keep in mind with what Haley just showed you as far as finding the right entry. Entries in MyFitnessPal are inputted by everyday people. Anyone could submit an entry into MyFitnessPal, which is why you really have to, like you saw her looking through the options. Obviously that can be tedious, but after a while you start to figure out like what kind of makes sense for the best option.
So if you don't have like a food label to compare it to or anything, then I just tried to choose it, like look at a different few options and just see which one makes the most sense using your tools of like, oh, this should have carbohydrates. Another big thing too is like sometimes it will say it has 500 calories and then I'll look at people's log and it will say that the food they chose had 0 grams of carbs, protein, fat, and it only showed the calories. And obviously it's not accurate because every food has macros.
The next quick piece we're going to talk about is referring to what units of measurement to select or click when you're in MyFitnessPal depending on the item that you're actually weighing.
My biggest recommendation, most of the times you're either gonna be in ounces or grams, especially on a food scale, it's gonna show you those things as well if you do use a food scale. So personally, I use ounces for any type of meat or protein. Also when I'm using or measuring liquids, grams pretty much for everything else. Vegetables, fruits, oats, nuts, nut butters, like a jar of peanut butter, the serving size might be 32 grams of peanut butter or something like that, where you're gonna use the gram feature for those things.
Tracking things specifically by weighing them is gonna get you so much more specific results versus estimating. So like, it would be hard to know what 100 grams of oats looks like if you're not used to weighing something like that. At least if you are estimating and you find a measurement like 1 cup, like that can help you a little bit more.
Use versus the measuring cup.
Yeah, versus just choosing like, oh, this one says 100 grams as a serving. Like that's probably what I'm having. So
yeah, I would definitely say that. We didn't really talk about cups, but if you're not using a food scale yet, I wouldn't choose grams or yet. You could do ounces probably because you can kind of guesstimate that based on the size of the palm of your hand, about 4 ounces or so. I would say probably using a cup. So say you're doing you have broccoli or something, you could do 1 cup cooked broccoli and actually put it in a measuring cup as best as possible. That's more accurate than just doing 100 grams broccoli, because you don't even know what that looks like if you're not weighing it. So the next thing I want to talk about really quick is kind of how to log things, especially when eating out and being accurate in those ways, because that can feel overwhelming. And a lot of people think like, oh, I'm eating out, how can I log this? There's no scan or barcode or anything like
and
that.
And I feel like it easily becomes an all or nothing mentality, yeah, where it's like, oh, I have no idea what this is, I'm just not logging it.
Yeah, it's better to ballpark than not at all. So I want to show you an example of typing in a restaurant menu. So we're going to talk about Chipotle, because that's a pretty common one, and how you can find their whole entire menu listed and individually log for what you're ordering.
So say, for example, I'm going to Chipotle for dinner. I can literally just type in Chipotle. Did I type that right? And then hit search, and then it's going to show me check marks of everything that they have. So I can hit multi-add, which is pretty cool, and then it'll allow me to choose multiple things. So I get guac, you can hit right here. Maybe I also get sour cream, and then I got the barbacoa. You can also type in things individually, so you could type in the lettuce, but they're usually listed here, lettuce. Maybe I get the mild salsa. So for example, let's just say I got all those things. I can hit all, add all five, and then it shows me all of those things from Chipotle. Yes, the serving sizes are gonna vary, but this is choosing the best option based off of what my fitness pal has listed. So always try to type in the names of like restaurants and see if anything comes up. You don't know what's listed in MyFitnessPal and what's not. Common chains are always listed.
So going on from there, we talked about Chipotle, but for example, maybe you're eating out somewhere generic that doesn't have those entries listed. We've seen a lot of times where people just type in one really generic thing and it doesn't make any sense when logging it. It's not super accurate. So they might type in chicken sandwich, but it's like, is that really what you got and what was listed on the menu? It usually has a more descriptive name. For example, it might say a grilled chicken flatbread with Chipotle sauce and bacon or something like that. So then you know, you can look at what's listed on the menu and you can kind of individually log those ingredients sometimes. I think that's a little bit more accurate than just typing in like chicken sandwich, because anything can come up. There's a million chicken sandwiches.
There could be a chicken sandwich that is a whole wheat bun and literally just a piece of chicken, yeah, or there can be a chicken sandwich with avocado, bacon, mayo, like all this stuff. So it sounds way more tedious than it actually is. It just requires like 5 or 6 entries, like maybe the bun, maybe the actual chicken, the avocado.
Just don't overwhelm yourself with that. Something like pizza, no, you don't need to do like pizza dough, sauce, yeah, cheese, like that's crazy. But same thing with that, trying to be specific. So for example, if you got like thin crust cheese pizza with spinach, like I would try to type in something like that than just writing like pizza, you know what I mean? Like the same thing, specific with your wording really helps. I love when my clients text me pictures of their food and the menu and they say like, how would you log this? I'm not really sure what to do. I love helping them with things like that. So if you work with us, make sure you ask us those things.
So obviously every food scale is gonna look different, but for this one in general, this is by the brand Taylor, you can adjust the units with the button right here. So we were at grams, we're going to ounces, we can click whatever we need to measure. So a big thing that a lot of people don't understand is how to get the accurate measurement when you're using something like a bowl or a plate. So what I would do is I'm gonna take my bowl, I'm gonna put it on top, and then there's a button over here that's also the on button that says tear. That's gonna take away the measurement of the bowl. So that's gonna give me a clean start. It's gonna say 0. And for example, if I wanted to put some oats on, just for example, what I just poured in there was 21 grams, and I don't have to worry about the weight of the bowl. I know that I have 21 grams of oats. Say I wanted to add my peanut butter in or something like that, again, I would just hit tear and then start fresh with every single ingredient.
Okay, the last thing to keep it super simple, and this is
like tough love.
Yeah, a tough pill to swallow sometimes. And like, come on, it happens to the best of us. You go in your cabinet, maybe eat a little Justin's peanut butter cup, and you're like, nobody saw that, doesn't matter, but it does matter. And the less stuff you log, the more inaccurate your log is gonna be, and the less your coach can help you. Because if we don't truly know what you're taking in, what we're doing isn't going to benefit you if we don't have the best data possible.
And sometimes it's intentional, sometimes it's not. I have people where I look and like all I'll see is like 8 ounces of chicken in their dinner, and I'm like, did you really only eat 8 ounces of chicken? That's the only thing you ate? And like sometimes I'll check with them, I'll say like, hey, is that really the only thing you ate? Sometimes they might say yes, and other times they're like, oh no, like I completely forgot, I got distracted, and I forgot to put in like my vegetables and my potato or something like that. And that's understandable. Versus when I've had clients where they eat
say they got like a bag of potato chips, let's just say for example, and then they measure out a serving and they log that in there, and then they end up telling me that they had the whole bag and they didn't log it. Like, I know that happens sometimes, and then you feel like scared
guilty
to log
or
it,
like yeah.
guilty because you don't want to see that it's going over, or you don't want me to see that you're overeating or anything like that. But like she said, the best thing to do is be honest, and I always talk about this, but you're building integrity with yourself as well. So if you lie to yourself or hide it, you're just going to feel shame and guilt, and we don't want to feel that way. So the best thing you can do is be honest with yourself. Even if you're going over in your specific calorie, macronutrient goals, it's better to be honest, and that can show us data, because sometimes it might be a good thing too. I've had people where they overate and then they realize like, oh, hey, I felt so much better in my workout the next day and whatnot. And maybe we're like, oh, maybe you need some more food. Some of these little hacks can really help you make logging a lot easier. And if you have any other questions, you can always let us know.
So just starting out with my FitnessPal, I know that it can seem kind of daunting with all of like the weighing and measuring we're talking about with a scale. If you're just starting out MyFitnessPal, you can use a lot of the tips that we suggested about just like estimating and using your best judgment to find the right entries. But if you're wondering like, should I get a scale? We would always recommend it, just for the fact of really seeing what you're taking in as far as serving sizes go, what the actual amounts are, and really zoning in on those specific numbers, especially if you have goals that you really want to achieve. You can only go so far with like eyeballing everything.
Yeah, and do you have to use a food scale for every single food all the time? No, but it can teach you portion sizes. If you have no clue what 4 ounces of chicken looks like, seeing it on your food scale can help you. And then in the future, when you're out to eat or you're not able to weigh something, or down the road when you're not using food scale anymore, you're able to kind of eyeball and say like, oh, that was about what 4 ounces looked like when I used to weigh it out. That's probably close. And I've done that before. I've tested myself. I've said like, oh, I would think that piece of chicken is 5 ounces and I weigh it, it might be like 4.5. And I'm like, dang, I'm good. And it just helps you build confidence when you're not able to use a food scale or track things like that. You can use your knowledge of serving sizes and stuff like that.
And I think that's a great way to end the video. The last thing that I would just want to say is this is all building skills and utilizing tools to help you really know what you're eating if you've never like tracked your food before. Are you going to use MyFitnessPal every day of your life until you're 90? No. Are you going to use a food scale? No. But this is teaching you how to eat and kind of know what you're eating. There's periods in my life where I've gone through not tracking for a couple months and then I'm back onto it. It teaches you along the way. It's not something you're going to do every day. So if it feels like overwhelming at first, don't think like, oh my God, how am I going to do this for 10 years? Like, that's not the case.
Definitely not. Yeah. It's a really good tool in the beginning to learn a lot of these things, but we definitely don't expect you to do it forever. And there's going to be periods of breaks and stuff like that, like she said. So
if there's anything we didn't cover or any questions you guys have, so drop those in the comments below if you have those. Otherwise, you can reach out to us directly on Instagram, either one of us.
Yeah.
And stay tuned for a video on what it's like to work with us specifically.
Quads Like Healing Nutrition, except we're going to rebrand. We don't know what yet.
You got a name?
Stay
drop
tuned.
That below.
Yeah, let us know.
Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.
Oh.